Hi there, Doug Stewart with IT Creations with a 2U Dell PowerEdge R7625 server. We did the R760 a few weeks back, and that one featured fourth generation Intel Xeon scalable processors with 112 cores and 224 virtual threads, assuming you install two top of the line 56 core CPUs. This one has dual fourth generation AMD EPYC CPUs and can deliver up to 256 physical cores and a staggering 512 virtual threads, again, using top of the line AMD EPYC processors. I think you can do the math. As always, I will mention cores aren't everything, but that is quite impressive. Hit that subscribe button if you're back for more. But in the meantime, let's take a closer look. As a general purpose platform, the Dell PowerEdge R7625 server is designed to support high performance computing, virtual desktop integration, and virtualized workloads. Not to mention, but I will, in-memory database, AI and inference, plus machine learning. Now, I always thought VDI was for virtual desktop infrastructure, but you know how this industry is. The more acronyms, the better. Along with support for CPUs with up to 128 cores each, you also get support for DDR5 memory modules, PCIe 5.0, and can install two double-wide GPUs or up to six single-wide with flexible storage. Again, we have a bunch of options supported on this platform, so I will not try to confuse the issue. Keep in mind, Dell states in their spec sheet from February of this year that future releases will include additional capacities and form factors. They also list only CPUs with up to 96 cores in that same spec sheet. Fast forward 3 months and we get 128 cores in the technical guide from May of this year. Where do all those cores come from? Fourth gen AMD EPYC CPUs used to top out at 96 cores. In answer to that question, AMD just released new fourth gen AMD EPYC CPUs on June 13th, 2023. Three are workload optimized for cloud native data centers and three more fourth generation CPUs with AMD 3D V-Cache technology for demanding high performance computing applications. At least so far. It is hard to keep track of all this stuff. If you will recall, when AMD 3D V-Cache was announced for the third generation processors, it enabled L3 cache of up to 768 megabytes compared to the standard 256 megabytes on most other third gen AMD EPYCs. The 968-4X processor with 4th Gen 3D V-Cache technology now offers 1,152 megabytes of L3 cache, which offers even better data queuing with faster access to data. The other CPUs, which are workload optimized for cloud-native data centers, provide that 128 core count with an L3 cache of 256 megabytes. All those cores are an asset for virtualized infrastructures too. Interested in the Dell PowerEdge R7625 server with 4th Gen AMD processors? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that you can configure or that's listed on our site at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for your quick path to IT Creations. And just mention this video to get that special offer, itcreations.com. AMD has compared these new CPUs to Ampere Ultra Max CPUs. AMD's new chips deliver a 3.7 times throughput performance increase for cloud native workloads and 2.7 times better energy efficiency. Even though energy efficiency is supposed to be one of the advantages of using ARM-based architecture CPUs. Kind of strange that AMD is now comparing their CPUs to Ampere Ultra ARM-based CPUs instead of Intel, but Ampere Ultra Max CPUs have crazy core counts too, at up to 128 cores. That's of course not mentioning Ampere 1 CPUs, which have a maximum core count of 192 cores. Again, different architecture compared to x86, and I'm getting off topic. Those last AMD EPYCs with AMD's 3D V-Cache technology may only have up to 96 cores, but still provide up to 5 times the performance gains compared to the previous generation for Azure HPv4 and HX instances. HPv4 and HX series virtual machines are good at scaling and cost-effective for applications in financial services, computational fluid dynamics, geoscience simulations, and all sorts of other high-performance computing applications. Did I mention that the ARM-based Ampere CPUs are single-threaded CPUs without hyper-threading like Intel and AMD? Whatever, let's just move on. Once we remove the optional LCD bezel, the platform has a number of storage options to choose from, just like the R760 server we did a few weeks back. 8 or 12 3.5-inch storage bays in front supporting SAS or SATA drive types, 8, 16, and 24 2.5-inch bay options with support for SAS, SATA, or NVMe Gen 5 U.2. That 24-bay chassis can support up to 368 terabytes. I'm gonna assume one of those additional capabilities aspects would be support for E3.S NVMe drives, up to 33% more than the previous generation to be exact. The technical guide lists options for 16 and 32 E3.S drive bays. However, only the 16 E3.S chassis has an option for a PERC H755N front PERC or one of those new H965i front PERCs that can raid those NVMe drives. The other 32-bay E3.S option uses the integrated S160 controller. Maximum storage capacity with 16 or 32 bays for the E3.S drive type is not listed. There are more storage options hosted in back, and we will get to those in a minute. The control panel on the right-hand side of the chassis has the power on button, a USB port, iDRAC Direct Micro AB USB port, and a VGA port to connect a monitor. On the other side, another panel with system health, system ID, and status LED indicators for drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe. The system ID button can also be paired with an optional iDRAC QuickSync 2 wireless indicator. That will allow you to quickly manage the system using an iOS or Android-based smartphone or tablet. Pretty much gives you access to most of the management features, including the system hardware, firmware inventory, diagnostic and troubleshooting, plus system inventory and a bunch of other items. On the back, there are two PSUs to either side with a number of options depending on the configuration. Configuration will affect PCIe slots too. There could be up to four PCIe slots featuring Gen 5 and up to 32 gigabit transfers per second, which is twice as fast as that supported by PCIe 4.0, or an option for eight PCIe 4.0 slots. If you add either the optional 2.5-inch, 2-bay, or 4-bay drive cages or GPUs, that will impact the number of PCIe slots available. The standard LOM module has one USB 2.0 port, an RJ45 iDRAC Ethernet port, one USB 3.0 port, plus an optional serial port and an optional VGA port. That space for the VGA port is optional because it can also be used to support direct liquid cooling, DLC. An optional OCP 3.0 card can also be installed, offering several bandwidth options from 1 gigabit Ethernet to 25 gigabit Ethernet with 1 to 4 ports. An embedded NIC offers dual 1 gigabit Ethernet ports and is optional as well. Just above, squeezed between the slots for risers 1 and riser 3, is a slot for an optional boot optimized storage system or BOS. The monolithic BOS N1 delivers two M.2 caddies and are accessible from the back of the system. With two M.2 drives, they can be added to a RAID 1 for mirroring. In the event of one of them fails, the other takes over. The BOS can also support just a single drive with a RAID 0 and a blank in the other slot. The PCIe risers are easily removable using the thumb screws and maybe a Phillips head screwdriver. As with all Dell PowerEdge servers, the R7625 can be managed using the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, or iDRAC. iDRAC can be used to manage a single server, and the Dell OpenManage application leverages iDRAC to provide multi-server management. Both can be accessed at chassis or, as the name would suggest, remotely. The R7625 comes with iDRAC Direct, but the license can be upgraded to support Enterprise or iDRAC Data Center. An OpenManage license can also be purchased and comes in Enterprise and Enterprise Advanced Plus, typically used to manage multiple servers. Once we take the cover off, you can see the basic layout. Drives up front, backplane, a row of 6 fans, then the plastic air shroud directing air over the CPUs and memory modules. Lastly, the PCIe risers with risers 1, 3, and 4 visible, and riser 2 in the middle under riser 3. That is assuming it came with those optional risers. This one has most of those things. It also is configured with optional GPU risers and the optional plastic shroud designed to effectively cool the GPUs. As cooling is essential for performance, outfitted with optional direct liquid cooling, the R7625 can achieve peak performance almost indefinitely. I feel like I'm saying optional too much, but I really don't have any other option. This system has riser configuration 4 with 2x16 low profile slots plus 2x8 full height slots and 2x16 slots with double width, full length risers installed. With only one PCIe 5.0x16 slot in each of the extended GPUs in risers 1 and 4 installed on our system, it will accept two double wide GPUs of up to 300 watts each. It has a performance fan kit and dual redundant 1400 watt power supply units in back. There are a few GPUs to choose from, including the NVIDIA A2, A16, A30, A40, and A100. Also an AMD card, the MI210 with 64 gigabytes of memory for high-performance computing and AI server applications. Oh yeah, this server will also tackle AI and HPC. None of these GPUs drain more than 300 watts. The R7625 has fewer memory module slots at 24 compared to 32 on the R7525. The interconnect on the 4th-gen AMD EPYCs is twice the speed at 32 gigabit transfers per second compared to 16 gigabit transfers per second on the 3rd-gen EPYC processors. It has a front PERC H965i controller, which is the latest 12th generation PERC. This controller will support SAS, SATA, and NVMe storage devices. It supports Gen 3 NVMe drives at 8 gigatransfers per second and 16 gigatransfers per second with Gen 4 NVMe drives at a maximum of a two-lane width. For Gen 2, SAS data rates are 6 gigabits per second, Gen 3 at 12 gigabits per second, and SAS Gen 4 at 22.5 gigabits per second. But we'll just round that up to 24 gigabits per second like they do in most of the materials I've read. To be clear, 22.5 gigabits per second is the data rate, while 24 gigabits per second is the link speed. It will also support SATA at 3 and 6 gigabits per second. Mixing speeds for SAS and SATA drives is not supported. However, you cannot mix NVMe with SAS or SATA drives with this controller. That said, it will support a full range of RAID options. This system offers better performance along with improved power efficiency for data center applications. Those fourth-gen processors also enable significantly better performance for a wide range of applications with DDR5 memory and PCI 5.0. In fact, it grabbed a new world record for accelerating in-memory databases by over 72%. It also delivers 33% more storage, a 55% increase in CPU performance per watt, 50% more cores, and 120% increase in performance in general. Oh, and with optional direct liquid cooling, improved energy efficiency from reduced cooling costs. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button or give us a thumbs up if subscribing is too much of a pledge. As always, it's good to know when we're providing some useful information, and it definitely helps the channel. To learn more about this server and potentially take advantage of that special offer, hit that button right there or use one in the links in the description below. Have any pressing questions on this server or some other server? Drop a comment in the section below. We will respond. Until next time, I'm Doug Stewart with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.